present to you a very exciting film. Mr. Emilios Koutsoptidis will perform for us a very funny comedy. Because it's a mystery, we don't know what the comedy is about. But that's one thing we can be sure about. It's going to be very, very funny. I present to you Mr. Emilios Koutsoptidis.
My family are very, very ordinary poor peasants. Some of them are shepherds, and some of them did little farming in Cyprus, a small village in Larnaca. I never thought I'd become an artist. I never knew I had the talent of an artist. My father gave me £5 and sent me off to England, you know. And eventually I became an art student, you know. That was like entering paradise for me. My brother got married in Leeds, and I went up there to visit him and stayed there and became an art student there. But I was very lucky, you know, because the Leeds College of Art in those days was the most advanced college of art in England. You know, it had some great members of the staff, you know, who are today are very famous artists.
I thought it was a very exciting place to be because it attracted very talented people.
The guiding light was Harry Thuprot, you know, a teacher of genius. And then he had among them Alan Davy, Terry Frost, Nip Stalwart, even you know, great personalities like Herbert Reed used to come round to the college. So I was very lucky in that respect to know these people. Then Terry Frost asked me to go down to St. Ives, you know, where he lived. And there I met more artists. And of course, that's the best education anybody can have, you know. My great hero is Ben Nicholson. I just love the way he operates.
Έψες η νύχτα σιωνίζε, λουλά μου, μαρουλά μου.
Έψες η νύχτα σιωνίζε, λουλά μου, μαρουλά μου.
Και τα πουλιά μαρακώσαν,
τρα-λα-λα-λα-λα-λα-λα, τρα-λα-λα-λα-λα-λα-λα, τρα-λα-λα-λα-λα-λα-λα-λα.
Και η γιόνι μες στα αγκαλιά σου, λουλά μου, μαρουλά μου.
Και η γιόνι μες στα αγκαλιά σου, λουλά μου, μαρουλά μου.
Κρύο την
έννοια... Thank you for coming. I think it's a good exhibition. and Natasha did a very good job. Now, what I'm trying to do with these words is not to show how clever I am. I think the world is full of clever people. What I want to do is make statements that move people. They move it. They make them feel better. They become better people. And that's what I want to do. Well, it doesn't sound very fashionable, but I don't care. You know, I mean, I've come to a stage when I want to express what's in my heart. I don't want to be fashionable. I don't care if I'm fashionable. This is the entrance to the College of Art in Lemba. The Great Wall of Lemba, as this entrance is called, it started in an accidental way. Originally, there was no wall separating the street from our yard. And we thought we'd build a wall. So we started building a low wall. Some of the material we used for the wall was debris left behind by students. It was work of art. They were works of art rejected by the students who finished their studies and went away. And we had a problem storing those. Anyway, we put these materials on the wall. Of course, being artists, you are always an artist, even when you build a wall. So we did not just place items on top of each other to make a wall. We started arranging things. And when you start arranging, you notice visual rhythms going on between items. And one thing led to another. The what was originally meant to be a wall started becoming a work of art. What you see around here is a major work of art. You know, somebody will appreciate it at some stage, yeah. Although it's not finished yet. You know, and it probably never finished. But even as it is unfinished, it's got quality. You know, and it counts as a major work of art.
Oh, definitely.
You know, it's certainly the biggest public sculpture in Cyprus. You know, I thought we'd keep doing this in an open-ended way. And when we fill the yard, then we fill the studios as well. We go to the roof of the building so that the College of Art becomes a work of art. You know, that was my intention at some way through. So I don't know if we'll ever manage to do that, you know, but it's a good idea. It's a romantic way to finish College of Art, you know, yeah, to transform it into a work of art. Thank you.
when I was in England, nobody took much notice of me, except like, you know, in 1960s, because of that, that's a court trial and a court case involving my work. And there was an interest then, and then I was forgotten totally. But at that time, I started getting jobs in colleges of art and being a real peasant. I thought that was the important thing. You know, I thought I couldn't deny myself the glory of teaching in a university, for example, you know, because I only did primary school education. Yeah. So it meant a lot to me, you know, to be a college professor. And I kind of neglected art. Well, I kept working. I never stopped working, but I stopped having exhibitions, you know, I didn't bother.
Look at this, eh?
I drag a bunch of plates.
Yeah. can you get this microphone?
And these are nice with the light on. I don't know if it register.
Συνεφιασμένη Κυριακή, μοιάζεις με την καρδιά μου που έχει πάντα συνεφιά.
Συνεφιά, Χριστέ και Πάχριστέ και Παναγιά,
έχει πάντα συνεφιά.
Συνεφιά, Χριστέ και Πάτριστέ και Παναγιά μου.
Σε μια μέρα σαν κι αυτή που χάσα τη χαρά μου. Συνεφιασμένη Κυριακή,
Κυριακή, μα τονιστή, μα τονιστή καρδιά μου.
Συνεφιασμένη Κυριακή,
Κυριακή, μα τονιστή, μα τονιστή καρδιά μου.
Όταν σε βλέπω προχερή στιγμή δεν ησυχάζω, μαύρη μου κάνεις τη ζωή.
Τη ζωή και
ήμουν κάπου 25 χρονών. Και αναμίχθηκα με... ήμουν στο Λονδίνο. Πια στο Λονδίνο για δουλειά, δεν είχε πια να σπουδάσω. Αναμίχθηκα με φοιτητές τέχνης, μέσω του Βότσου. Ο Βότσος ήταν φοιτητής τότε. Σε πολεμική κοινωνία. Και θαύμασα αυτούς τους ανθρώπους, ο τρόπος που ζούσαν, ο τρόπος που μιλούσαν, έναν είδος ελευθερίας που δεν είχαμε στην Κύπρο, προπαντών στην εποχή μου εμένα. Και ήθελα πάση θυσία να μπω μέσα σε αυτήν την κοινωνία. Ναι. Και σιγά σιγά πήγαινα στις καλερί, άκουγα τι μιλούσαν, τι έλεγαν. Και σιγά σιγά αυξήθηκε το ενδιαφέρον μου στη ζωγραφική. Και μέσω του Βότση φυσικά. Σε μια περίπτωση, ο αδερφός μου παντρεύτηκε στο Λίτς. Και έφυγε από το Λονδίνο και πήγε στο Λίτς. Και μια ημέρα αποφάσισα και πήγαμε στο κολέγιο τέχνης και τρύπωτο να γραφτώ part-time φοιτητής. Όταν έμπηκαμε έτσι το χώρο, σαν που να μπαίνα στον παράδεισο. Που βλέπα ανθρώπους να εργάζονται, να δημιουργούν τέχνη και ο τρόπος που μιλούσα για την τέχνη. Οπωσδήποτε, δεν προσπαθούσα να γίνω και εγώ όπως τους άλλους,
αλλά δεν τα
κατάφερνα, δεν μπορούσα να, γιατί τότε έπρεπε να κάνεις ακαδημιακή δουλειά. Να σχεδιάζεις όπως τον Νταβίτσι και τον Μάικλ Άγγελο. Προσπαθούσα, δεν τα κατάφερνα, κατάλαβες. Ξαφνικά άλλαξε ο διευθυντής του κολεγίου και ήταν ο Χάρη Τούπλου, ο άνθρωπος μεγαλοθείας. Μεγάλος δασκαλός που ανακάλυψε το Foundation Course, που άλλαξε τη διδασκαλία τέχνης στον όλο τον κόσμο. Όπως είπατε, μόλις μπήκε μέσα, λέει μου εσύ τι κάνεις, να προσπαθώ να σχεδιάσω. Γιατί τότε σε πρέπει να μάθεις να σχεδιάσεις και μετά να επιτρέπεται να πιάσεις που γίνεσαι να σου γράφεις. Λένε μου αφού δεν τα κατάφερνες με το βολίο, πιάσε κάτι διάλλοντε. Λένε μου μα τι αφού δεν επιτρέπεται. Μα ποιος είπε να επιτρέπεται. Δώστε μου λίες φωλιές, λέει. Έδωσα μου λίες φωλιές. Λένε μου αν έκανα έναν πίνακα, να στυλράει. Ακόμα ένα. Ακόμα έκανα 7 την ίδια ημέρα. Εγώ έτσι πάω στο πάτωμα και φέρνω τους φοιτητές όλους να δουν πραγματική τέχνη. Όχι ακαδημαϊκή που κάναμε προηγουμένως. Αυτή είναι η πραγματική τέχνη. Που τότε, που λέμε οι Εγγλές, I never look back. Από το ψηλότερο φοιτητή να γίνω στόρος φοιτητής.
Trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue, clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying how do you do. They're really saying I love you. I hear babies cry, I watch them grow. They're like much more than I ever knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
You see, I grew up in 1960s, you know, which was a golden age in College of Savoy. And then in 1970s, when the conservatives came to power, everything changed. The final straw was when somebody said to me, I got to be cost effective. But cost effective, what does that mean? You know, do you measure the sizes of canvases? How do you measure cost effectiveness, you know? Alex,